Hello guys, and welcome to C programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. In the previous tutorial we discussed about how to write and run C program in Windows. That is, first we used a text editor, that is Notepad. We wrote our Hello World program. After that we downloaded and installed MinGW compiler suite. Next, using command prompt, we executed our first program, that is Hello World program. That is the one way to run C program in Windows. And another way is we can use IDE to run C programs. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment. That is, it is a suite which contains all the development tools which are required to develop a program. So today in this tutorial, we are downloading and installing an IDE. And we'll see how to run C programs using IDE. So we are using CodeBlocks here. So now we'll see how to download CodeBlocks, and after that we'll see how to install that in Windows. Okay, to download CodeBlocks, first we need to open any browser, and in the address bar type codeblocks.org. That is the official site of CodeBlocks. And press enter. It will redirect us to the CodeBlocks page, and here we can see all the information about CodeBlocks. And next, here we can see download option, downloads. Click on that, and here we can see the different ways of download. That is, download the binary release. And next we can see the explanation about that. Next, download the source code, and here we can see the explanation. Next, receive source code from SVN. There are three types, but here we are downloading the binary release because this is the easy way of installing CodeBlocks. And here we are installing a setup file, and next we'll run that in our computer. Okay, next here we can see, select the package depending on your platform. That is, if you are using Windows, then you can see files here. Okay, here we can see 16.01 is the latest version. And we can see setup file, non-setup file, and MinGW. In the previous tutorial, we discussed about the MinGW compiler suite, right? MinGW means Minimalist GNU for Windows. This is a compiler. So if we download this file, then it contains MinGW compiler suite. Okay, so here we can see download from SourceForge. We can also download from the PostHub. We'll download this from SourceForge.net. We need a setup file. So we are downloading CodeBlocks 16.01 MinGW setup.exe. from sourceforge.net. So it will redirect us to the sourceforge.net page, and download will start shortly. And here we can see a pop-up message, that is download CodeBlocks setup.exe, and just go to the save option and it will start downloading. It has 79.90 MB. So it will take some time, but I already downloaded this file, so I won't download it again. Okay, so I'll cancel this because I already have this file. Okay, once the downloading process is done, we need to install this file. So I'll go to the downloads, and here we can see our file, that is CodeBlocks 16.01 MinGW setup file. So I'll double click on that. Okay, this will ask, do you want to allow this app from an unknown publisher to make changes to your device? Yes. So I'll click on yes. So here, welcome to CodeBlocks setup. Here I'll click the next button, and this is about the license agreement, and I'll click on I agree. And here you can select the components, that is here we can see plugins, launcher, compiler suit. Here I won't change anything. I'll click on next, and here we can see the destination folder. That is, you can choose the install location. By default it is C program files, so I won't change this also. So I'll keep this same. So I'll go to the install. So it will start installation process, and in the desktop we can see the CodeBlocks icon. So wait for some time. Okay, now do you want to run CodeBlocks now? If you want, you can give yes or no. I don't want to run now, so I'll give no. So I'll click on next. So now we are done with the CodeBlocks setup installation. So I'll give finish. Okay, so I'll close this. Now here we can see the CodeBlocks icon, right? I'll double click on that. That means I'm opening CodeBlocks. So this is the CodeBlocks home page, and here we can see the management window. Okay, so this is the log and others. That is, here we'll see how to write the program. So for that I'll go to the file, and here we can see the new option. So in that I'll select project. And here we can see the different types of projects. So I'll go to the console application and click on go. So I'll click next here, and here we need to select the language, C or C++. I'll select C. Next. Okay, here we need to give the project title. So I'll give as first program. So here I'll give as first program. So here we need to select the location of our project. So I'll click here, and I'll select the location as desktop. That is, I want to save my file in the desktop. So I'll click here. So select OK. Next, I'll click on the next. So here this is about the compilers, and here I won't change anything. Here we can see compiler is GNU GCC compiler. I want this compiler only, so I won't change anything here. I'll click on the finish. Here in the management section, here we can see our project name, that is first program. Here we can see sources. Here I'll click on the plus button. Here we can see main.c. If I click this, here we can see the default code, that is hello world program, right? Now we'll see how to run this code. Once you write the code, you need to go to file and you need to save that file. Okay, and the next thing is you need to go to build and click on the build, or you can press Control F9. So this is compilation process. So once we wrote the program, we need to compile that. So we'll go to the build menu and we'll click on the build option. Okay, in the log section we can see zero errors, zero warning. Okay, so that means compilation is successful. There are no errors in our program. Okay, so now our program is compiled. Now we need to run this. So I'll go to the build menu, and here we can see run option. I'll click on that, and here we can see the output, that is hello world, right? Okay, this is about the downloading and installing CodeBlocks IDE. And that's it for now. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. I'll meet you in next class. Till then, take care.